with Jack Traynor still on R&R, and I might add, not courtesy of the stewards, but on his own volition, his right-hand man Jack Brown is going to step in to discuss the prospects of the stable run as a Club and Angle on Saturday night. Well, Jack, good to catch up with the boss away. No doubt everything's been running very smoothly at the stables.
Yeah, everything's been rolling really good, and horses are getting worked, and we've got a couple of people there helping, so all working out really good.
Jack, a few interesting runners there on Saturday night. In the second, Surface has drawn a bit wide in a tougher assignment, coming off two excellent performances in winning at Penrith, courtesy of two fine drives by you, I might add. It wasn't disgraced when fifth behind Always Rocking here last week, beating 8.5 metres.
Yeah, his two wins at Penrith were really good. He had two good runs in behind the leader, and he was super both times. And last week was first time going running them big miles, and he didn't disgrace himself at all. He sort of went 150, and he was finished in the pack. So now, hopefully that run will switch him on, and he can come back this week and go a bit better.
You've drawn virtually the middle of the line. Where do you see Surface being?
Oh, he sort of usually just goes back, and he's sort of very fast for 200, as everyone knows. And I think he'd just go back to his usual pattern and go back and flash home late.
On a personal note, you must be pleased with your performances, with the opportunities you're getting lately.
Yeah, getting some really good opportunities off Jack, and good to get drives off Mick Harvey as well, a big owner, and getting really good opportunities at the moment.
Now, Jack, in the third, Spirit of Anzac emerged from a form slump with three solid performances, which included a win, but well beaten last time out behind Boom.
Yeah, last week was probably a bit of a blur. We should have locked that one out. There was a bit of a false start at the start of the race, and he got a bit revved up and pulling a bit hard, and he doesn't really sort of seem to race good when he pulls. So hopefully we can just forget about last week and go into this week fresh. And he's had a good freshen up last couple of weeks, and I think he'll be going better this week.
So you will be expecting a better run. So midfield once again, as far as the draw is concerned.
Yeah, the outside draw. We've been going back with him, and he's actually been hitting the line quite hard. So we're just driving the same, and he'll be hitting the line as good.
That race five, very tough, but the draw has helped for our weight. This is the best draw he's had since joining Jack's stable.
Yeah, he's been one of them horses that's had no luck since coming here, and he's got luck on Saturday night. And last week's run was good. They just went slow up front, and if the speed's on, he's sitting away on the fence, and he's very fast. As his first start for us, he ran a crazy half, and hopefully this week's the week, and if he gets the right run, he'll be thereabouts.
Well, Jack, with the reserve out, he gets barrier one, so he will get a nice soft run with all the major players drawn wide.
Yeah, that's the main good way for him to get that draw, and hopefully he can sit up on the fence, and he'll be thereabouts.
And if people are playing exotics, he must go in.
Yeah, 100%. He's a class horse, as everyone knows. He's been a good horse for so many years, so hopefully he can get another win on the board, and hopefully it's Saturday night.
The sixth event, no doubt the stable would love to win this race. It's named in honour of Stylish Memphis, the stable star. It's a group event. We've got BK Spy and Town Echo. First of all, BK Spy, Jack scratched it last time out because of a blood reading.
Yeah, as the cold weather comes in, you know, you get the viruses, you get the colds, but she seems really good. Her bloods are well now, and she's brightened up, picked up really well, and her work's really good. So I'm hopefully to see a new BK Spy this week, and I think she'll be hitting the line really good.
Chan Echo won 5 on end, then when third to Yoha, beaten 5 metres, worked a line very gamely.
Yeah, she's actually quite a class mare. She probably, when she first got here, she just looked like being just a mare, but she's really worked on now, and she's a really nice mare. So she's very versatile. She can do anything, go back, go forward, and I think if she gets wherever she needs to be, and she'll be thereabouts.
Yeah, she's drawn out wide, but you've got Yarraman Bella with speed drawn inside. Fairy Tinkerbell, no doubt the one to be drawn out wide.
Yeah, 100%. Maybe if they light her up off the gate early, I'm not quite sure the way she's going to be driven, but if she's thereabouts and the speed's on, and they'll definitely know she's there.
And Jack will be back from his holiday to fulfil some of these commitments on Saturday?
Yeah, Jack will be back. He's had a week off. It's pretty hard to do in this game to get a week off, but it's good to get for him to get a week off, and good to be trusted with these horses.
And Jack, it's always good to have a week off and the stewards are not involved.
That's good for him to get away and, in Bali, so which is good, and he'll really enjoy it.
Jack, as always, thanks very much. Good luck with the horses on Saturday night, and continue your good form in the sulky.
Thanks, mate.